Okay, so I'm ready to start wireframing and created a new project here and titled it Zen App, saved it so we have autosave going. I added a first page that has an application map. So this is just basically an overview of the screens we're going to design. This is a first release, so our minimum viable product is going to include just our landing page, the menu, and adding items from the menu, modifying them perhaps, and then adding them to the cart and paying. So all the yellow stickies are what we're going to design. The gray ones we're going to do later in another release. So we're not going to cover that here. So to get started, I want to add our first wireframe to do the landing page. I'm going to use this new mockup icon at the top. And we have a blank screen here. Now all we're going to do is sketch out the first page. So we're really kind of thinking through the design here. So I'm going to put in just some boxes. The viewport, so this is going to be a landscape view, so I'm going to make it 800 by 600. And we're going to have a persistent menu at the top. So I'm going to just create a box using the R key and clicking and dragging to draw that rectangle. I'll use another quick add for the logo. And let's do another quick draw, rather, and for the menu button on the left and the carts that'll appear on the top right. I'll have a welcome message in the main part of the screen. So I'm going to hold the Y key actually here and do the title, quick draw. I'm going to hold the T key just to drop in a block of text placeholder. That should be the intro or instructions. And the right here could be our specials. I'll put a subtitle above each one using the Y key and quick drawing here again for each of these blocks and just kind of tweak the spacing a little bit and center it. So this is good to go. I'm going to start to transform now the outer parts of our wrapper. So we want to have a button that says menu in the upper left. I'll rename that and then bump the size up a little bit. We don't need an icon, so I'll just bump the size up to 16 maybe here. And let's see, our logo, we'll just use a title for now. Control T or Command T on a Mac to transform this to title. And just rename it Zen, hold shift and arrow up to nudge it. It's good. And we'll do an icon and label here for our cart. So let's type icon to transform this to icon and select icon and label. I'm going to change this to say cart with a zero indicator to start and left align the icon. Look for the cart icon in the icon search box. Nudge it down a bit in size and then put it in, align it or tweak the alignment around here. And this looks decent. So let's turn this into a control we can use on all of our wireframes. I'm going to select the header here and the viewport and group this. So have all that selected. I did not select the text blocks and go to the edit menu and select group. Should turn blue here to show that we have a group selected. Let's make it a symbol. So I'm going to use the group inspector under the name area and type in app template and convert it to symbol. Turns green to show that we have a symbol there. And then if I go to the UI library, it shows up and quick add should show the app template as well. To rename this wireframe landing. All right. So the next thing we're doing here is we're going to design what happens when you tap that menu button, click or tap. So let's see, what should happen is an off-screen menu should slide in. So let's create a new view here. We're going to clone the landing page and rename this clone menu. So what we want to do is show that this menu button is selected. So let's edit, so let's override this symbol and just change the state of the menu button for this instance. So we double click the symbol, we selected the menu item, and we changed the state property there. All right, so let's add a list control. This is gonna be our slide in menu that comes from the left of screen. And we're gonna just, we could resize this. Here I'm just holding shift, control alt, and arrow keying. You can also use the handles. I'm going to change the font size and make an alternate row color here. And let's see, let's give it a little bit of height. I have a text file with our menu items, so I'm going to copy that, paste it into the list. All right, looks decent. The design here should probably be that our first menu item, so we should always have a menu item selected, and we'll have a wider menu here that shows the items underneath that selection. So let's select sides from the inspector and then put in another panel. So this will be the sort of sub menu for the selected item. Panel will be populated with each of the sub items, and let's draw a picture of each item. So this is an image of the first side that I'm drawing here, and just kind of put a label in there. And I know the first one's called edamame. First, let's transform the image. Okay, we have a good placeholder image, and let's see, center that one and put in edamame. And here we have the first item. Have a horizontal rule to separate each item. Put that right underneath this guy. All right, good. So I could probably group this and duplicate it a bunch of times. And then I will just go ahead and rename those guys. All right, so we're back and these guys are renamed. These are all the sub items under sides. And the idea now is I want to show what happens when you click Takkos, for instance. I cloned that wireframe, made a new one, renamed it Takkos. Let's show the selection for this wireframe as Takkos. And let's just go ahead and change all the names of these items to have taco names. All right, I went ahead and filled in all the names here. So here's our sub items showing Takkos. And now the idea for this next part of the flow that I want to create is that you selected one of these, like this Chuck Norris chicken. What'll happen is the landing page with all the menu showing changes to a new view for Takkos. So let's use the symbol for the app template and create a new wireframe here. All right, so we have our basic setup now. We have our landing page. We have figured out what our menu is going to look like and how it's going to work. And the next section, we're going to start filling out the wireframe for one of these sections. We're going to do tacos, and we're going to figure out the detail screens for ordering a taco, and then we'll go on to looking at the cart.